GTM Podcast Episode 27 Blessing 4 Living in Amenable Location Part 1 Introduction. Hello everyone. You are listening to GTM Podcast. We have now to cover the first group of blessings. And in this episode, we are beginning on our second group of blessings, turning towards wholesomeness. It is rare to find a system of spiritual wisdom that has environmental considerations built into its metaphysics. The possible exception is the Chinese Feng Shui system, which probably has its roots in Buddhism anyway. In science, by contrast, there is always a great debate in developmental biology about the relative influence of the genetic component and the formative experience, the so-called nature versus nurture debate. For science, of course, it is mostly considerations of the development of physical features like a color or a size which might have an influence in the survival of the fittest. But for spiritual wisdom, we are more interested in the development of spiritual maturity. However, no less than with the science, the blessing of life recognizes that there is influence both by our internal dispositions, nature, and our environmental influence, nurture. The fourth blessing on amenable location is the first blessing of the second grouping of blessings, which deals with turning toward wholesome discretion. If we have practiced the first three blessings successfully, we will already have turning our back on negative discretion. In this set of three blessings, the first, which is blessing four, deal with nurture influence of environment on the development of our discretion. The second group, which is blessing 5, deals with the nature influence on the development of our discretion. And the sixth deal with having a clear aim or purpose in one's life. All three together are necessary if we want to set ourselves on the path of development of spiritual maturity. Thus, in Buddhism, it is acknowledged that the environment must be good if people are to become good. If the environment lacks virtue, it will hinder people's spiritual growth. Blessing 4. Living in an amenable location. Amenability of location in general. Generally speaking, an appropriate or amenable location is one which facilitates success in what we set out to do. If we are a fisherman, then it might be a place on the coast closer to the fish breeding grounds. If we are in business, then it might be a place with all the hustle and bustle of the crowds where our business will prosper. And what if we are monks? Monks need a place with special characteristics. A place that is both peaceful and quiet, but not too far from the homestead of the village. For soldiers, an amenable location is a strategic one. In conclusion, each and every profession and activity had its own appropriate location for facilitating success. The word location can equally well be applied to the microcosm, the setting of a particular activity, as it can to the macrocosm. Even if you are sitting at a dining table, sitting at one side of the table might be more or less amenable than sitting at the other. The location that most concerns a person or his activities is his immediate environment or neighborhood. But the more distant environments of his locality or country also have a part to play. Amenability in Dhamma practice. The sort of location to be examined in this blessing is the location amenable to refining the mind, or put another way, the location that facilitates the depth by which we can understand the teaching of the Lord Buddha. In such an amenable location, even though a person may initially lack wisdom, he can make a success of his life. On the contrary, in an unamenable location, even though he may have a high IQ and be capable, given no support, there is no way for him to achieve his full potential. Even though someone might get a PhD, if he is marooned on a desert island, all his knowledge goes to waste. You might be the world's greatest tactician, but if you are forced to live in the forest with primitive tribal people, all your knowledge will go to waste. The factors that mark an amenable location also apply to appropriate areas to live. The Lord Buddha highlighted four factors which make a location amenable. These are 1. Amenable location. 2. Amenable food. 3. Amenable neighbors. 4. Amenable Dharma teachings. Amenable is not the same as materially prosperous. In many materially prosperous countries, life can be physically convenient. Often the infrastructure is well developed. Employment is easy to find and it is easy for residents to save up their wealth. On the surface, such a country might look attractive to live in, but one won't forget that although material poverty might be hard to find, spiritual poverty might be rife. In such a country, the opportunity and the means to develop spiritual maturity might be very hard to find. The chance to accrue merit might be almost non-existent. Residents in such countries think only of work from the time they get up in the morning to the time they go to sleep at night. Thoughts of generosity, self-discipline, or meditation might be the last thing on their minds. Even for those who have some spiritual calling, often they can find no one to give them useful advice. To live in such a country might be life waste from the point of view of spiritual development. It would be better to make some sacrifice of material convenience in choosing the place you want to live, in order to live in an environment of spiritual richness, which is truly an amenable environment for one's spiritual progress. So everyone, now we have learned the importance of living in amenable location that can help us in spiritual growth. In the next episode, we will talk more about the component that is support making location become amenable location. So stay tuned in the next episode, GTM Podcast.